Even at a time when many companies are making large profits, millions of South Africans are suffering as a result of rising prices of everything they buy. As a government of national unity, we will look to expand the basket of essential food items. Food items exempt from VAT and undertake a comprehensive review of administered prices, including, yes, the fuel price formula, to identify and this we did for a while. When the prices of fuel just kept on rising, we were able to find a way in which we could stabilize the price. We will seek to find ways of addressing this challenge. Over the next 5 years, we will seize the enormous opportunity in renewable energy for inclusive growth. South Africa has some of the best solar and wind resources in the world. As we undertake a just transition towards renewable energy, our country must create a green manufacturing sector centered on the export of green hydrogen and associated products. We must move into electric vehicles and renewable energy components. We have seen, for example, how the Northern Cape has already attracted billions of rands of investment in renewable energy projects. Work is underway to set up a special economic zone in Bukhubai to drive investment in green hydrogen energy projects. We have already a huge pipeline of renewable energy projects representing over 22,500 megawatts of new generating capacity, estimated to be worth around 400 billion rand in new investment. Investments such as these will inevitably create more jobs. Now, over the next five years, government will focus on expanding and strengthening the transmission network, the electricity transmission network that needs a great deal of expansion, but that also requires quite a lot of investment. To drive inclusive growth, we need an efficient freight rail network to carry our minerals, our agricultural produce, and manufactured goods to market. Through the implementation of the freight logistics roadmap, we will continue with reforms to transform South Africa's freight logistics system. The well-being of our people and growth of our economy depends on another important issue, which is water. South Africa is a water-scarce country, and our water security is threatened by historical underinvestment in bulk water resources and distribution infrastructure. We will therefore continue with the institutional reforms in the water sector to enable greater investment in bulk water infrastructure and better regulation of water services and sources across the country. Just as business needs water and electricity to operate, a growing economy needs skills. Where the skills we need are not immediately available, we need to attract people with the appropriate qualifications and experience to come and bolster our efforts. Now, in doing this, we will continue with the visa reforms that we introduced in the last few years to attract skills, but more importantly, to also attract investment, and also with a view of growing our tourism. Like many other countries, we have had to borrow money to support our budgetary requirements. We will manage public finances with a view to stabilizing debt. We are firmly committed to steadily reducing the cost of servicing our debt so that we can redirect funds towards other critical social and economic needs.